Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot with a super exciting update video for Jurassic World Evolution, because it turns out IGN have been able to play another 20 minutes of the game. Now, this is not a new 20 minutes of gameplay. It is the same first 20 minutes that we've all seen already from the LA footage. But what it is a new build of the game. It's a newer development build. It is still development build. It's worth keeping that in mind. But it's newer development build, so a lot of stuff has been added, some really cool stuff. I'm going to link that video down below. Thank you to Sagasol, who told me about it in the first place. But I've already gone through and picked out the 6 or 7 or so most important things that we learn from that video, and I'm going to talk through them with you tonight. So let's get started. I've got my red brush and I've got my slideshow. So the first thing is the addition of the free camera. This is just a little quality of life thing. If you missed, well, I'll just point it out first of all, down here in the bottom we now have three cameras. It's also worth noting, by the RS, the X and the B, this is actually our first gameplay footage from a console version of Jurassic World Evolution. Anyways, so one of the problems I had with Evolution from my own gameplay was that when you're viewing your dinosaurs, you know, the Struthiomimus has just walked out of the Hammond Creation Lab, the camera is kind of inexplicably tied to the ground, and you can see it here in this view. It's kind of tied to around here. It doesn't really move that way anymore, so it doesn't let you get sort of a higher angle of your dinosaur. And I took issue with that. It actually annoyed me when I was playing the game, and I told Nick Rogers that. I'm sure other people who play the game said the same thing. So it's really nice to see that we now have a free camera in the game. So basically we can stick to your default dinosaur view, or you click that button, you can zoom out, you can rotate a little bit more, and get sort of a more controllable view of your dinosaur, which is what I will use every single time. So it's just a nice little thing that really shows that Frontier are listening, so it's really good to see. Moving on, number 2, unique music and voice announcements. So if you go to about 1355 in the video, you'll see this Edmontosaurus being released. I need to breathe, bloody Nora. And as it's released, this really lovely little piece of music plays. Now, that music is not the same music that plays when the Struthiomimus is released, so it is at least somewhat unique to the Edmontosaurus. I don't think every dinosaur will have unique music the first time you release it, probably, that seems like a lot of work, but maybe the Hadrosaurs have their own music and the Stegosaurs have their own music, something like that. Maybe the bigger herbivores and the smaller herbivores have different music. It's just a nice little way to give each dinosaur a little bit extra specialness, which also goes along with the second thing. You can hear it through all of them when all the dinosaurs are released in the video, but particularly during the Edmontosaurus. You can hear this female announcement blaring over the tannoy, announcing the Edmontosaurus arriving at your park. It's just like in J-Pog when you got a dinosaur for the first time and they said, "Watch out for those raptors." That's my female voice, apparently. It's just a nice little addition, nice little quality of life, nice little, just a little bit of oomph to your park, you know, when dinosaur first gets announced, rings out over the tannoy, all your guests hear, you know, T-Rex is now live in the park. That's a really cool thing to hear, and just a nice little addition, really, not a big deal, but just all comes together to make the game better. Moving on, wrong one, this one. So we have two things on this one as well. Again, tiny little additions. First things first, well, second, I guess. These little icons, I don't believe they were there before. I could actually be entirely wrong now that I start to think about it. But there's little diet icons next to the dinosaurs in the dig site. Are they herbivorous? Are they carnivorous? Little icon will tell you. I think they may have been there, but from my own recollection, they weren't, and I couldn't be bothered checking. So maybe ignore that one. But I wasn't sure if this was here as well. This is new fossils discovered. Both of these could have been there for all I know. But what I really like about this is, instead of, if you look back at JPOG, you unlock a dig site, you basically clear through that dig site, and then you move on to the next. The idea of being able to unlock sort of the more exciting dinosaurs down the line means that, okay, maybe you've cleared out 5 dig sites or something, you've got all the dinosaurs you want from them, but then maybe 3-4 hours into the game, you upgrade your fossil collection mechanics, you know, your scientists become more adept, and maybe you have to go back to the earlier dig sites to get new appearing dinosaurs. It just means you're going to mix and match a little bit with your dig teams, which I kind of like the sound of, especially given we have so many dig sites to explore this time. More exciting stuff here though, unique guests. Just look here, I'm going to, you know what, I'm going to do some CSI level, dum dum dum. It's hard to see from this, go do watch it in motion, but one of the problems I definitely had when playing the game, and one I've brought up a few times, is there's this weird thing where your guests were based on kind of what tree you followed in the game. If you went for entertainment, you had entertainment guests. If you went for security, you had security guards. If you went for science, you had like guys in lab coats walking around your park. It didn't really make any sense whatsoever. One or two, sure, makes a little sense. but that made no sense. But what this is clearly a sign that we've got individual guests. Okay, these two at the back are basically identical, but there's a dude here in a massive white shirt, woman rolling around a black tank top, this woman's got a pink, purplish shirt, they've got pink shirts, there's someone here in like a beige thing, just mixing it up a little bit, making them more interesting to look at. Another new addition, largely unnoticed so far, the gate, look at this right here. Okay, I'm gonna make that bigger as well. This is really cool. Again, this wasn't here before, but it's something that fits so well into the canon, you know, it's now part of Jurassic Park. Even in the first film, of course, you had the big Jurassic Park gate as you drove through, but even in Jurassic World, and we've seen it in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, you've got this Jurassic World gate that opens up around the monorail. It's just a nice little thing to see added to the game, because it just makes your park feel so much more like the actual Jurassic World or the actual Jurassic Park. So that monorail gate has been added up there. Makes it all a little bit more interesting for me. It's so hot, guys. Oh, bloody Nora. Right, last one, and the most exciting in the entire blimmin' list. Let's go. Vajonka Junk. We have a confirmed number of dinosaurs. Now, this is only a development build. There could be more, in theory. I would wager that this is the final number of dinosaurs. I would wager that this right here, 42, is the number of dinosaurs in the game. That does not, we believe, include the Indominus Rex, so it could be 43 at launch. And what's also really interesting about this is actually in alphabetical order, so we can recognize some of the dinosaurs here. We've got Chasmosaurus, Dilophosaurus, Deinonychus. It does seem they've been trying to show us these earlier dinosaurs. Ankylosaurus, Camarasaurus, Brachiosaurus. This one over here is new. That's Coryphosaurus. There's pretty much nothing else it could be. That right there is Craxinosaurus, and so it does mean these deluxe edition dinosaurs are included in the 42. And then there's this new Stegosaur right here on the left. There's a little bit of speculation about what that could be, but the prevailing thought right now is that it's Chung Kingosaurus, which is really cool because it's a really obscure Stegosaurid that 99% of people have not heard of. And I love that Frontier have gone with these. Like, even if it's not Chung, even if it's something else, it is definitely an obscure Stegosaurid that most people will never have heard of, no matter what, it has to be. So just having those odd little dinosaurs in there that, you know, it educates people about these new dinosaurs. It's interesting to look at. It spices our parks up a little bit. I'm really excited to see stuff like that in the game. And we know all the rest on this list anyway. Apatosaurus? Apatosaurus. Apatosaurus, Brachiosaurus, Camarasaurus. Archaeonophimimus. Right, that's all of them. That's all the dinosaurs on that page there. And then the four that were actually included in the demo. So then these 42 dinosaurs, possibly 43. But what is also very interesting, so we go from Ankylosaurus, and then Apatosaurus, Archaeonophimimus, Brachiosaurus. Three dinosaurs beginning with an A. What isn't there? Allosaurus. What is a big dinosaur in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom? Allosaurus. This, for me personally, sort of confirms there is going to be a Fallen Kingdom DLC when the film gets its worldwide release. I've talked about this multiple times, that the game comes out about 10 days before Fallen Kingdom does, so it makes sense they'd want to hold back some of the Fallen Kingdom dinosaurs. I don't see a world where, for a start, wait, where's Ceratosaurus? Oh yeah, Ceratosaurus is there. Carnotaurus isn't there either, Allosaurus isn't there, Baryonyx isn't there. What are the chances those three dinosaurs don't end up in the game? For me, pretty much zero. They are big parts of Fallen Kingdom. It wouldn't make sense for them not to be in the game, yet none of them are on that list where they would be in reality. So that to me says that DLC is definitely going to happen. We'll talk about that later this week, but that could add 5 to 6 dinosaurs easily, especially if you include the Indoraptor. We could be looking within 2 weeks of release at nearly 50 dinosaurs in the final game, which is just so awesome to hear. Oh, I'm so excited. So what did we learn today? We know the final dinosaur number, including Deluxe, 42. Great number of dinosaurs, that's not a problem. We have monorail gates, we have more interesting guests, we have little updates to the dig teams, we have voice announcements, we have free cameras, and we have unique pieces of music for the unveiling of the dinosaurs. Did I miss anything else? Go check out those gameplay videos, watch them for yourselves, consume them, and we wait for the next bits of information. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Apologies, this video's a little bit slapdash. I've had a long day and I'm boiling and it's hot and I'm just tired and blah, 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 blah. But I just had to talk to somebody about this, and my somebody is you guys at home. I'm super excited, 42 dinosaurs. Some really obscure ones. I know loads of you are going to be really excited about Coryphosaurus as well. Some people were a little sad that Cintasaurus being in the game. People thought maybe that means Coryphosaurus won't be in the game, but hey, there it is. Good times. Thank you so much for joining me. Please do hit that like button if you enjoyed this messy video. And do remember to subscribe to be kept up to date with the latest news in Jurassic World Evolution. This is the place to be. Thanks for joining me again. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Quick little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.